In this video, I'm gonna show you how easily we can create such an amazing effect inside the Figma. So get sure to watch this video until the end. My name is Kia and here is the kimo. Welcome back to my channel. First, I'm gonna design a user interface. I'm gonna keep it very simple. I would like to have a page including the navigation bar and a hero section. In the hero section, I would like to have a headline, paragraph text, and CTA. To make this page looks a bit more appealing, I'm gonna add some illustration to it. Okay, now it's time to work on the effect itself. I'm gonna make a rectangle inside my canvas, then increase the corner radius until I have a full circle. Then I'm gonna change the background color to something a bit lighter and more exciting. I'm gonna add the layer blur effect into this layer and increase the blurriness until we have very soft shape. Here I stop at 44 pixels. I renamed this layer to highlight, and then I'm gonna duplicate it. In a new variant, I'm gonna set the transparency of the background color to 0. Let's rename the new layer to default. Then I'm gonna select the ball shape and create a component set from them. Now I'm gonna open the prototype panel and then select the first shape or the default version and connect it to the second one, which is the highlight version. In the interaction setting, I'm gonna set the interaction trigger to the while hovering, and then the interaction type to change to. I'm gonna set the transition type to smart animate, and then animation duration something around 300 milliseconds. Now I'm gonna make a new frame which has the same exact size of the design that we made, and then copy paste the component that we made inside it. Now I'm gonna duplicate the instances that we already added into our frame, and then select both and apply the auto layout on them. I set the auto layout type on the wrapping. Now it's time to duplicate the instance that we have until we cover the whole frame. Let's copy paste this frame into the design that we have. And because I use the auto layout here in my design, I need to set the absolute positioning for the frame that I copy paste there, and then take care of the order of the layers until I position all the elements that we have, including navigation bar and the hero section, above the background effect. Now let's play the preview and see the result. And as you can see in the preview, the effect that we would like to have is working well. Just the animation is not as smooth as I expected to have. So I'm gonna do 3 more steps until I get the final result. The first step is that I'm gonna scale up the effect layer that I have in the design that the effect can cover more area. I'm gonna select the same frame and apply the layer blur on it and increase the amount of blurriness until I have very smooth animation. This blurriness will help us to cover those jumps in the animation. And the last step, I'm gonna go back to the component that we made and then select the highlight variant and then change the color to something more sharp that I have more contrast with the background. Now let's check again the preview. And this time, as you can see, the effect is smoother and the color is more proper. I hope you learned something new in this video. And if it was so, please do not forget to like this video, share it with your friends, and share your opinion and feedback in the comment section. And please take your time and subscribe to my channel right now. Let's learn together and see you in the next video.